Hi, this is problem number 2 on moment of inertia. Here it is asked to find the moment of inertia about the centroidal axis, means Ixx and Iyy we need to find here. Okay, and it is also asked to find the radius of gyration as well. Okay, first we will find the moment of inertia, later on we will see how to find the radius of gyration. Okay. Now just check the symmetry of the figure. The figure is not symmetric about x-axis and the figure is not symmetric about y-axis also, correct? It is unsymmetric about both axes and we have to find this Ixx and Iyy by using these formula only, okay? So before going to solve the problem, we'll draw the reference axis. Okay, reference axis is here. It is already drawn in the figure. This is reference axis 1 1, axis 1 1, and axis 2 2. Now figure is unsymmetric about both axes. So as I said, we have to find the Ixx and Iyy using these formulae. Okay, you just see what are all the things which are there in this formula. Here in these formula we have area values, right? Area values are there, then x values are there, x values, then ax is there. Okay, ax means to find the x bar we need ax value, correct? Sigma ax by sigma a. So we need to find ax, then ax square is there, ax square is there, okay, and igy is there, okay. So these are all the things required to find iyy, okay. To find ixx we need y values, ay values. Ay means sigma ay by sigma a. To find the y bar we need ay, and ay square is there here, ay square. Okay, and igx means all the values are there. Means here what we have to find, we have to find area values x, ax, ax square. Then we need to find area values, y values, ay, ay square, igx and igy. So in the table you need to include all these parameters. Okay, in the table you need to include all the parameters. Okay. So here we have the table which includes all the parameters: component, area, x, xy, ax, ay, ax square, ay square, igx and igy. Okay. Now the figure is divided into three rectangles. The whole figure. This is rectangle number 1. This is rectangle number 2 and rectangle number 3. Okay. We will perform the calculations for each and every rectangles. Now. First component is rectangle number 1. For that area is B into D, which is equal to width of rectangle 1 is 120, depth is 10. 120 into 10. So it will be 1200 mm square. Write the units: millimeter square, millimeter, millimeter, millimeter cube, millimeter cube, millimeter raised to 4, millimeter raised to 4, millimeter raised to 4, and millimeter raised to 4. Okay. Then coming to the x value for rectangle 1, means distance of, if I take g1 as centroid of rectangle 1, g2 as centroid of rectangle 2, and g3 as centroid of rectangle 3. X value means distance of centroid of rectangle 1 from reference 2 axis. Reference 2 axis, it is 120 divided by 2. Okay, 120 divided by 2, 120 by 2, 60 mm. Okay, coming to the y value, distance of g1 from reference 1 axis. Okay, from its base it is 5 mm from its base. but you want distance of g1 from reference 1 axis. That is what the y value for rectangle 1. So it is 10 plus this depth, it is not given. Overall depth is 120 mm. Out of 120, if you deduct 10 mm and 10 mm, you will get 100 mm as depth of rectangle 2. Okay. So g1, distance of g1 from reference 2 axis, means y value for rectangle 1 will be 10 plus 100 plus 5 mm. 10 plus 100 plus 5 mm. So it will be how much? 115 mm. 115. Okay. Now we will perform the calculation for rectangle 2. Rectangle 2, area is width into depth. So width of rectangle 2 is how much? It is 12 mm. It is given as 12 mm. Depth is 100. 12 into 100, it will be 1200. Coming to the x value for rectangle 2, means distance of g2 from reference 2 axis, it is how much? Thickness is 12 mm, 12 divided by 2, 6 mm. So here 12 by 2, 6 mm. And y value for rectangle 2, distance of g2 from reference 1 axis, this distance, it will be 10 mm plus 100 divided by 2. 10 plus 100 by 2, it will be 60 mm. Okay. Then for rectangle 3, width into depth. Therefore, width of rectangle 3 is 180, depth is 10. 180 into 10, it will be 1800 mm square. X value means distance of g3 from reference y axis, reference 2 axis, it is 180 divided by 2. 180 divided by 2, 90 millimeter. Y value means distance of g3 from reference 1 axis, it is 10 divided by 2, 5 mm. 5 mm. Now we will calculate ax value, then ax square value, 1200 into 60, 72,000. Coming to the ax square, it is 4.32 into 10 power 6. Then ay, 1200 into 115, 1200 into 115, it is 1,38,000. 1,38,000. Then ay square, it is 15.87 into 10 power 6. 15.87 into 10 power 6. Okay. 15.87 into 10 power 6. Then igx for rectangle 1. Okay. We know the formula for rectangle. It is bdq by 12. Bdq by 12. It is 120 into 10 cube divided by 12, and IGY is dbq by 12, 10 into 120 cube divided by 12. Okay, we will calculate the answer. 120 into 10 cube means 1000 divided by 12, it is 10,000. And 10 into 120 cube divided by 12, 10 into 120 cube divided by 12, it is 1.44 into 10 power 6, 1.44 into 10 power 6. Then ax value for rectangle 2, 1200 into 6, 7200. Then ax square will be 1200 into 36, 43200. Ay value will be 1200 into 60. 72,000. AY square will be 1200 into 60 square. 1200 into 60 square. It is 4.32 into 10 power 6. 4.32 into 10 power 6. Here BDQ by 12 is the formula. 12 into 100 cube. Divided by 12. Okay, 12 into 100 cube divided by 12. 100 cube, 100 cube, it is 1 into 10 power 6. 1 into 10 power 6, it is dB cube by 12 here. 100 into 12 cube divided by 12, 100 into 12 cube divided by 12, 14,400. Then for rectangle 3, 1800 into 90, 1800 into 90. 1,62,000. AX square will be 14.58 into 10 power 6. 14.58 into 10 power 6. Coming to the AY, 1,800 into 5. 1,800 into 5. 9,000. And AY square will be 1,800 into 25. 1,800 into 25. 45,000. IGX is again same formula, BDQ by 12, which is equal to 180 into 10 cube. 180 into 10 cube divided by 12. 180 into 10 cube divided by 12, 15,000. Here it is dB cube by 12. 10 into 180 cube divided by 12. 10 into 180 cube. 10 into 180 cube divided by 12, 4.86 into 10 power 6, 4.86 into 10 power 6. Now we will calculate all the summations. Total area will be sigma a is equal to 1200 plus 1200, 2400 plus 1800, 4200. Then sigma ax is equal to 72,000 plus 7200 plus 1,62,000. It is 2,41,200 or 241.2 into 10 power 3. Sigma AY is equal to 138,000. Plus 72,000 plus 9,000. It is 2,19,000. 2,19,000. Then sigma AX square is equal to 4.32 × 10⁶. 4.32 × 10⁶ plus 43,200 plus 14.58 × 10⁶. 18.94 × 10⁶. Into 10⁶, then sigma AY square is equal to 15.87 × 10⁶ plus 4.32 × 10⁶. Plus 45,000. It is 20.23 × 10⁶. Into 10⁶. Coming to the sigma IGX, it is 10,000 plus 1 × 10⁶ plus 15,000. It is 1.025 × 10⁶. Sigma IGX is equal to 1.025 × 10⁶. 1.025 × 10⁶. Then sigma IGY is equal to 1.44 × 10⁶ plus 14,400 plus 4.86 × 10⁶ into 10⁶. It is 6.31 × 10⁶. 6.31 × 10⁶. Okay. Now we will use the first formula here. Okay, this one. I11 is equal to sigma IGX plus sigma EY square. Plus sigma AY square. Sigma AGX is 1.025 × 10⁶ plus sigma AY square plus sigma AY square is 20.23 × 10⁶. So 1.025 plus 20.23. 1.025 plus 20.23. The answer is 21.255 × 10⁶. Now we will use the second formula. I11 is equal to IXX plus A into Y bar square. I11 is equal to IXX plus A into Y bar square. We will rewrite this equation. IXX is equal to I11 minus A into Y bar square. Okay, so calculate the Y bar. Y bar is equal to sigma AY by sigma A Sigma AY is how much? It is 2,19,000 divided by 4,200. 2,19,000 divided by 4,200 divided by 4,200. 52.14 millimeter. 52.14 millimeter is the answer. Now substitute in this equation. Therefore, IXX is equal to I11 is 21.255 into 10 power 6 minus total area 4200 into y bar square 52.14 square. Okay, so 21.255 into exponential 6 minus 4200 into 52.14 square. The answer is 9.83 into 10 power 6. 9.83 into 10 power 6 millimeter raised to 4. Okay. So this is the final answer for moment of inertia about x axis. Similarly, to find moment of inertia about y axis, remaining two formulae we have to utilize. In that, I will take the first formula. I22 is equal to sigma igy plus sigma ix square. I22 is equal to sigma igy plus sigma ax square, which is equal to sigma igy is 6.31 into 10 power 6 into 10 power 6 plus sigma ax square is 18.94 into 10 power 6. 94 into 10 power 6. So 6.31 plus 18.94. It is 25.25. into 10 power 6 mm to the power of 4. Now we will use the last formula. I22 is equal to IYY plus I22 is equal to IYY plus A into X power square. Okay. So we will rewrite this formula. IYY is equal to I22 minus A into x bar square. We need x bar. We know the formula for x bar. X bar is equal to sigma ax by sigma a. Sigma ax is how much? 241.2 into 10 power 3. 10 power 3 divided by total area 4200. 241.2 into 10 power 3. Into 10 power 3 divided by 4200. It is 57.42 millimeter. 57.42 millimeter. Now substitute in this equation. Therefore, IYY is equal to I22, that is 25.25 into 10 power 6 minus area into x bar square. 4200 into x power 57.42 square. By this we will get IYY 25.25 into 10 power 6 into 10 power 6 minus 4200 into 57.42 square. The answer is 11.4 into 10 power 6. 11.4 into 10 power 6 millimeter raised to 4. This is final answer for moment of inertia about y axis. Okay. So in the question, it is also asked to find the radius of gyration. Okay. We know the formula for radius of gyration, that is k is equal to I pi y therefore kx is equal to root of ixx divided by total area. Root of ixx is moment of inertia about x axis, that is 9.83 into 10 power 6 divided by 4200. Let me calculate the answer. 9.83 into 10 power 6 divided by 4200. Root of answer 48.37 millimeter. Okay. Similarly, ky is equal to radius of gyration about y axis, iyy divided by total area. Iyy is 11.4 into 10 power 6 divided by total area 4200. Therefore, 11.4 into 10 power 6 divided by 4200. Root of answer 52.09 millimeter. 52.09 millimeter. Okay. So this is radius of gyration about y axis. In the question, it is asked to find least radius of gyration. Okay. Out of these two radius of gyration values, which is the least one? Kx is the least one. Therefore, finally, you can write, therefore, least radius of gyration is equal to 48.37 millimeter. Okay. So, to this, we have done with the solution of this particular problem. If you have got any doubts in any steps or any of the calculation, you can post your doubt in the comment box. Okay. Thank you.